This is a tale of quest and conquest, a struggle for land and legacy. Its twists and turns take 3 years to unfold. It begins in winter, just before sunrise. For the Druid Peak Pack, the Lamar Valley in northern Yellowstone has always been home. The Druids have ruled this valley for 8 years. At their peak, they were a great clan of 37 wolves, one of the largest wolf packs ever recorded. But that was almost 2 years ago, when their leader was in his prime. He's known by the research collar he wears as Wolf Number 21. Come April, he will turn 9 years old. Having lived almost twice as long as the average wolf in the wild, he's one of the oldest wolves in the Northern Range. Yet, along with his mate, Alpha Female 42, he still keeps the Druids together, helping to feed and protect them. The early morning howl was no casual conversation. It was the Druid call to arms. Wolves are born to hunt, and Lamar Valley is the finest hunting ground in all of Yellowstone. Each winter, some 2,000 elk from Yellowstone's northern herd descend into Lamar. The valley is surrounded by mountains and sheltered from the deepest snow. But though the valley is the key to the elk's survival, here they must face the wolves. Young druids leap forward, full of speed and stamina. They chase and test the elk. Chase and test until they find a weakness. Old 21 gamely plays his part. The youngsters do most of the legwork, but when it's over, all the druids share the reward. A pack this size must kill every 2 or 3 days, and this supports many other residents of the valley. Ravens and magpies are so quick on the scene, They often beat the rest of the clan to the kill. And it's not just food they're after. A pair of ravens makes off with a bit of fur, perfect for renovating their nest this time of year. But scavengers need to be cautious. It's always wise to give wolves a wide berth. The little red fox has second thoughts. He won't return until the druids are long gone. But this pair of coyotes can be too bold for their own good. While the wolves are still at the carcass, the smart move is to hang back. Sometimes wolves are willing to share, but more often, they get touchy about their hard-earned property. But the druids are too full to move. If they haven't eaten in several days, they will gorge and consume 20 pounds in a single meal. About all they can manage now is a nap. Still, the coyotes approach with caution. They can never be sure when wolves will turn. And there's just something about coyotes that sets them off. The druids are not out for blood this time, but the coyote couple has had a scare. They'll get no share of the wolves' kill now, and must catch a meal on their own. Rustling around in the frozen grass, a vole gets careless. This is the coyote's usual prey. At least this much of the valley is his. The coyote couple settles down for the night. As mates, they share a territory in the valley and a bond that will last for life. A hardy flock of waxwings has been feeding on juniper berries all winter. And in Yellowstone, that's 6 months long. Yet with 2 months of winter still to go, a hint of spring is in the air. A lone black wolf is coming to call on the druids. He's not just any wolf. He is 302, the most notorious flirt in Yellowstone. He comes from a clan almost 20 miles away, but all the druids know him well. This is the second year he has approached the pack. XXI and his mate are not exactly pleased to see him. Their daughter, however, can hardly contain herself. Thank you. 302 keeps one eye on the daughter and one on the old man. Finally, 21 has had enough. 302 beats a hasty retreat. He's more of a Casanova, a lover, not a fighter. He wants no part of challenging the old chief. The daughter slinks home to her mother. But this is a battle parents never win. Their daughter's longing is beyond their control. This is the mating season, and not just for wolves. The mating season is something coyotes and wolves have in common, and the little coyote couple heads off for a moment to themselves. In 2 months, both coyotes and wolves will give birth, and the valley will become the playground of a new generation of pups. The next day, the Casanova is back for more. He courts the females, but what he really wants is to join the clan, an idea that seems to agree with all the Druid daughters. Though this is the usual way a wolf changes clans, the alpha pair will not allow it. Together, they send the Casanova packing. The old couple still makes a formidable team. They restore order to their valley, but it won't last for long. They are at the end of their reign.